Yeah, we're ready.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
I think we're live.
I think we're live. We just have to make sure. Are we live? We think we're live. Just Facebook takes a little bit of time to catch up.
Right.
People to come in. I'm Francis Matthews and wait for a few more people. Okay. Just give it about 10 seconds.
You all right? Yeah,
everything's all right. Yeah.
Gone well, has it, that?
I was hoping not to drop them. How's your cough?
A little bit, I had a crisp before we started, so it's a bit bad.
Oh, that's all right. That's bad. I've got a bit of a cough myself, so I think we'll be on.
So we're ready. Come on, let's go.
Right. Okay, welcome to the Ball Draw, the most anticipated event of the last 3 years. Now, we've done this, I think this is our fifth time. Originally, we were in Southport and we'd done this with some special DJs, Andy Whitby
and Sam Townend.
Sam Townend. Then we moved and we did it with Anne Savage and Paul Maddox. Then we moved again to London. Nick Frost
and
Lucifer.
It was
Lucifer,
yeah.
And then the last time we'd done a weekender, which was Tidy 21 back in 2016, we did it with Nick Frost again, and we did it with Mark E.G. Now, before we go on, I must apologise. Nick Frost was invited, but unfortunately, he's filming in South Africa and can't be with us, so he does send his regards. However, the good news is, he says, "Can you put my ball in the draw?"
Yes, indeed.
So he can't be with us tonight, but he wants to DJ at the weekender. His ball is in that draw. Now, just to let you know, if you've never watched this before, this is live, so anything can go wrong. We've got 150 balls in this glass jar there, which was purchased from Amazon. And what it is, these 150 DJs are hoping to be pulled out to play at Tidy 25 Weekender, which takes place when?
On the 10th and 11th of July, Amadeus.
Summer in Prestatyn. Unbelievable. So, these DJs, there's people like Patrick Toppin, Eats Everything, Carl Cox, DJ Jean's in there. So anything could happen tonight. Also, Nick Denton and some of your favourites are in there as well. So we have a mixed bunch. There's 150 DJs, but only 86, I believe, can come out. Only 86.
So how's it going to work?
Well, if you've never seen it before, Andy, and you have, so you should have asked that question. What happens is, shall we introduce the guests?
Absolutely. Two gentlemen stood there.
Two.
Very attractive.
Very, well, one of them is. now, to the left there in the far with the silver hair and the wonderful smile is Lee Haslam. Now, Lee is a big part of Tidy 25, in fact, a big part of Tidy's history.
He is indeed.
So he had to be our special guest. A big round of applause for Lee.
Nice to be here. Thank you.
Very upstanding, gentlemen.
He's come all the way from Doncaster, I believe.
Yes.
Good trip.
Okay.
Very good. Now, Lee's role is to put his hand in the balls, pull one out, shout the number, and we'll have an interesting fact about the DJ. Now, to Lee's right, we've got somebody, because Lee plays mamby-pamby trance, we thought we want somebody with a bit of a fierce edge. So we thought, and is the same height, we thought we'd bring Brent Stevens. There we go.
Brent? Who's Brent?
Brent Stevens. It's not Brent.
No.
All these years. But that's why my emails have not been getting to you.
Oh, it could be.
I need to check my inbox and outbox. They've all been going to Brent Stevens. Not paying attention to the hard house scene, me.
No.
So it's Ben Stevens, apparently, and Lee Haslam, which is fantastic to
it's
have.
Great news.
And they're both the same height, which is perfect for this tonight's broadcast. So,
yes,
Andy, are you ready? Nervous?
So I've got a list, and you've got a list.
Yeah.
We've got all the DJs in there.
Yeah.
How many? 85, wasn't it?
Round about 85, 86, I believe. I lost count.
So only two nights this time.
Two nights at the Weekender, which was perfect for people who have got babies or
elderly relatives.
Elderly relatives or children. So it's two nights, 10th, 11th, but you can stay over on the Sunday. There's a lazy Sunday and also a naughty Thursday. If you go to tidy25.com, all the details are here. We're live. Now, I can see a lot of people are posting up messages because we're live. We can't talk to you tonight during this because it's just a bit tense.
It's tense. It's very, very,
very tense.
Yeah. Who knows what's going to happen?
So please stay with us for the next 6 hours as we go through this special thing. Now, there's only one criteria. We've got some camera crew here and they may giggle, but the two guests must not laugh.
You must not laugh.
Must not laugh.
It's serious.
I think they're going to be okay.
All right.
Although Lee laughs at anything.
He does, to be fair.
You see, he's laughing now. Now, just get that out of your system, Lee. Okay. Go on, big laugh.
there we go.
Ben? No.
He's a very serious DJ.
Very serious DJ. Very serious.
Vicious circle.
So are we all ready?
By the way, you keep pushing me away from the podium. I'm in the curtain again.
Sorry.
With your big shoulders.
Sorry.
Right, come on, let's get going.
So, Lee, I think you're going to... Oh, Ben's... Ben what?
Ben's going first.
We had a toss before we came on, didn't we? And Ben was the first one to draw it. So what you need to do is pull one out, show it to the camera, shout the number out to me or Andy, and drop it in your little sack.
I think I can do that.
Yeah, okay.
So have a little stir with your hand.
No, don't look. First number, it's very tense.
So the first number is 61.
61. You've got that one, I think.
I've got 61 on my sheet. So, the first DJ confirmed at the Weekender is BK. The hard house producer legend who gave us all those Nucleus classics is back at the Weekender. Now, interesting fact, he likes to stir other people's coffee when they're not looking, and his favourite part of the tennis racket is indeed the handle. So BK, the first up at the Weekender.
Very good.
Over to you, Mr. Haslam.
Get your fist in.
Wow, number 114.
114, now that's at the back of my list, I believe, because that's, I can't, did you just drop that on the floor then? Is that 114? We've got to pick these up later. 114 is the 12-inch thumpers. 12-inch thumpers, look into camera there. The good thing about the 12-inch thumpers is, it says that's been crossed out. Okay, 12-inch thumpers, Alan Proster, renowned for their banging bounce. Alan has a nephew called Thomas who is allergic to toffee.
Is that right? Okay, let's get some pace going here.
Yeah, let's speed it up with...
Back to you, Ben.
Back to you,
Ben. A lot of people tense at home.
So, number 59.
59, that's
number you. 59. Number 59. It's a lady.
Oh.
It's a tidy girl. Lisa Pinnock, the queen of bounce, has played at virtually every Weekender over the 18 years. She loves to watch caterpillars fight and enjoys cycling along cobbled streets. Mm-hmm. What an image.
What an image. I can just picture on a cobbled street. Well done to Lisa. Congratulations. Go for it, Lee. Let's keep the pace up and the tension's there. You can smell it.
Number two.
That's me. And that is base jumper. Real name Martin Cook. His new hobby is collecting rubber johnnies from all around the world. He's even got some from Poland.
He'll be very pleased.
Well done, Martin Cook.
Okay, let's go.
We're on fire.
Number 20.
Number 20. Aha. Number 20 is Ed Reel. Mm-hmm. You may be familiar with his work. He's the DJ produced from Riot and Nucleus. Now, what a lovely man with very long fingers. In fact, his fingers are so long that he struggles to peel fruit. And he hates horses being forced to canter. And that's a nice thing. He hates it.
Hates it. I've seen him.
Stop, he says.
Stop cantering.
So Ed Reel is at the Weekender. Reel.
Come on, then. Come on, Lee. Keep it going. Was that a grin?
Number 22.
Number 22, I've got that one. Kim Ayres is back. Firm, tidy favourite. She loves to DJ and smile at the same time. Biggest claim to fame is spitting on the back of Gary Barlow's hair while he was...
Whoa. Sorry. Three strikes and you're out. Okay, carry on. Sorry.
Her biggest claim to fame is spitting on the back of Gary Barlow's hair while buying an ice cream in Portsmouth.
True story. Very true, true story.
Okay, who's next? Didn't think Ben would laugh first, did he?
No.
102.
That's 102. You. Now then, you'll be pleased about this because I know he's a big favourite of yours. It's the one and only Paul Maddox, who's been part of the Tiny production team for 20 years, Lee, yes. You'll remember. And we believe he's played at every Tiny Weekender. We have to check that, of course. Now, a little interesting fact, and I think you've told me this once, Lee. Paul loves to draw peacocks when they're laying down. You've seen the pictures, I believe. Yes. So Paul Maddox, he's on.
It's going well so far. Oh, you can write all these names down as you go along. Play a little game with us.
Number 75.
75, that's me. It's good that he's coming out alternate, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's Alex Kidd. There you go. Big cheer at the back there. Yep. Alex Kidd. Weekender superstar who's famous for his unannounced legendary Shally party, if you remember that. Yes, Alex me. Once tried to milk a horse and made claims that not all...
No, you can't laugh.
And made claims that not all crabs walk sideways. He says he has video footage to prove it.
That's funny. He tried to milk a horse.
He did try milk a horse, but haven't we all? Who's next? Not much fun.
23.
That's you again.
23. Tall Paul.
Oh.
A true legend in his own right. Paul's been championing the harder scene since Tidy began in 1995. Although, Paul's biggest fear is to leave his coat in the back of an ambulance. Little known fact.
That's my biggest fear as well. Next.
Number 28.
28, I think it's you again. I haven't got 28.
28.
Oh, no, I've got it. 28, sorry. JP and Jukesy. There we go. JP and Jukesy. It says here, very popular Weekender DJs, the Midland-based duo. Many have done great parties at Storm and Ecstatic, of course. They both hate the smell of stale soap that can get trapped under someone's wedding ring. Next. Must take that off.
Yeah,
115. It's a duo.
Go on.
Ali Wilson and Matt Smallwood.
Oh, they've not played for ages.
No. So it's very good to see them back at the weekend and return to Hard House. You've seen them do this.
Yeah.
They both have a natural talent to be able to work out if a train is going to stop at a station. Unique talent. I'm sure you'll agree. Ali Wilson and Matt Smallwood.
Number 17.
Doing well. Number 17. That's me. Oh, it's John Hemming. He'll be pleased. John has recently rose to fame with the Shed antics, of course. Until recently, he used to think that men's penises were all the same size.
Are they not?
No. He hates clocks that tick too loud. And his favourite thing to draw is clouds.
Hundred and thirty-three.
Another girl, Amber D. Now, ooh, actually, Amber found her fame when she came second in the DJ competition for the Tidy Weekend. Was it the first one?
I think it was the first or the second. I can't be sure.
Now, a little-known fact: she loves to comb her hair in the front of other people's mirrors, and she one day hopes to meet an Afro-Caribbean snooker player.
Don't we all? Right, who's next? Balls are going down.
Number 127.
Is that Calvin Harris? No, it's not. It's Illogic. And Illogic's real name, by the way, is Gus Wainwright. His biggest fear is to be bummed by a zookeeper, and he hates it when cats sneeze.
True facts, aren't they? All these
are true facts. Spent months on
these
this.
We've researched this.
Number 37.
That's you.
Number 37. A little surprise. I think this is going to please a lot of you. Ingo.
Ooh.
He's going to return to bounce things up at the Tidy Weekender. Now, it's a bit sad, this one.
Oh, go on.
So, tragically, Ingo's too scared to own a pet because he knows they don't live very long. And he would be too upset to see a dead animal in his kitchen.
Oh dear, that's sad. I know how he feels though.
Number 48
is Paul King. Now, Paul King produced some massive anthems for Tidy over the years under different guises. And he said if his ball came out this time, he would wank into a biscuit tin until it was completely full of spunk.
Wow, it's a lot of spunk.
Send in a video. Send in a video.
Number 15.
Aha. Now then, we are changing musical styles here. Hardcore Fun is back at the Tidy Weekender with the legend Scott Brown. Now, Scott recently tried to fit 240 teaspoons into the back pocket of his jeans while roller skating from Derby to Leicester, a charity stunt that backfired and didn't even make the local paper.
What a waste of time.
But Scott Brown returns to the weekend.
What a waste of time.
Number 38.
38 is me. I've got to find... Oh, now, This is probably the biggest surprise so far. Smoking Bert Cooper. Oh. Now, he had a track out on Tidy ages ago. Never DJed at a Tidy event or a Weekender. So this is a bit of a world exclusive. He did, obviously, the track Getting Warm. He makes his Tidy debut here. He said, not a lot of people know this, but he's fascinated by the way that moths eat people's clothes.
Mm.
Number 95.
Thank you, Ben. Number 95, Mr. Robert, Sir Robert Tessera, I would say. Now, Rob is clearly one of the hardest working men in Hard House. Rob's actually played every Tidy Weekender, that's a fact. But he's 83 years old and puts his young looks down to expensive soap, playing rugby with teenagers and eating plenty of raisins, currants and sultanas.
Same thing, I think, aren't they? Need to check that out.
Number 39.
Congratulations. Tidy boys.
Oh, I'm crushing you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, it's always a bit scary when we do this ball draw because, like I said, if our name didn't come out, we'd sulk. The greatest DJ, it says here, the greatest DJ in the world, better than Ferry Corson, Roger Sanchez and Dahul. Expect something special on the Friday night.
Mm. Look forward to them.
There we go. Ben, you're doing very well, by the way.
Thank you very much. Number 86.
Ooh.
Number 86, a good friend of ours.
Go on.
And he's going to be very pleased. Digital Mafia.
Oh, well done. I think he's somewhere at the back there.
I think he is lurking in the back there. He's in the back. So, Dave Jackson, the loveliest man in Hard House.
Yep.
I think you'll agree. Now, if Dave laid down, two Daves laid down side by side, they would be the same width as a bus driver's gear stick. That's two Dave Jacksons laid down side by side. Imagine it. It's a long stick. That's what you've got with two
so
Dave Jacksons.
So that's the width of two Dave Jacksons.
Yes, the width of two Dave Jacksons.
Number six.
Number six. Thank you very much, Andy. I've got this one. It is Nick Denton. I know his ball's in there. It's not. It's been far too long, it says here. I don't know who wrote this. If you saw him naked, you would know that his legs are darker than his arms. And it's something his mum's quite embarrassed by.
Have you seen that?
I have seen, well, I saw a photo on the internet. I didn't believe it was true. poor Nick Denton.
Number 43.
43, is that?
Number 43, now then. No expense spared here, obviously, because we're going international. This is DJ Scott Project.
Oh.
Yeah. Lee was pleased with that one. So he returns to the Tidy Weekender, originally from Frankfurt and one of the pioneers of hard trance. Worth knowing this, his lucky motto is never climb trees that have less than 36 branches. And he likes to spend time with nuns who can't read. it's a true fact. We spoke to him.
Number 13.
Number 13, that is me, Andy. Do you mind?
You on your own, DJ?
Yeah. No, no.
Oh, right.
It's Paul James, one of the pioneers of Hard House and one of the boys at the beginning of Tidy. Yeah. He has to be playing. He's got the largest collection of vinegar bottles in Europe and he's currently writing a book about why fog doesn't last very long.
That's good. It's going to be a good read, Lee, that.
Riveting.
Really good read.
97.
Steve Arnold. Steve loves to play trance even in the winter. However, now, honestly, this is a bit serious. He does have a very rare disability, which makes him dribble when he sees people looking at planes. However, his lucky soup is oxtail. Steve Arnold.
Number 121.
121, do you mind if I take a drink? This one's quite...
I think it's going well. So far, lineup's looking good. Please, Ben, with...
Yes, so far.
A lot of good comments online, I can see there, Andy.
Yeah, nice mix of talent.
Yeah. You'll
agree, boys.
Well, what number was that, by the way?
121, I think it was.
Can we check? 121. We'll just double check on that. It was 121. Okay, good job it is, because it's the Brain Bashers. I'm not sure they've ever played at a Weekender. It's been a long time since we saw them. Graham and Rachel make a return to Tidy. Did you know that they both hate the way that giraffes walk? And Graham once asked his doctor to take his watch to bits.
Is that right?
Yeah. Good to see the Brain Bashers. Balls are going down.
144.
It's a big number.
That's me. 144. I think you like this fella. Adam M. Adam M.
Good.
A little bit tougher. The hard man is back. Now, Adam's favourite part of the lorry are the big tyres, he tells me. He loves to drink Ribena very slowly, and only two things scare him, and that is a rusty bike chain or baby zebras.
Both doing well.
Number 122.
Number 122. That's Jas van Houten from Holland. Yes. This is good news. Massive hard-ass producer from Holland. Comes to a weekend of debut. Jas hates it when leaves fall off the trees in autumn and also wishes that rabbits and badgers would mate to form a new animal.
I'd like to see that. Yeah. I really would.
76.
Oh, here we go. Oh, now then. The judge returns. The judge returns. Now, Jules has played many weekenders and actually broadcast live, did he not, on Radio 1 from the Tidy Weekender number 8, which number was eight. Where? Where was that?
That was in Prestatyn. It was a cowboy weekender.
Now, Jules has recently had all his toenails removed so that he can put his socks on quicker in the mornings. That's a good tip.
That is logic. Oh, can I just stop before you put that? A lot of people have been saying, what about the DJs that were in the DJ poll?
Of course, yeah.
Now, what it is once we've done the regular DJs in this, we will be pulling two balls out and telling you who has won the DJ poll. Two lucky winners. The last 26 weeks, we've had DJs playing in this room every week, and there will be two lucky winners announced at the end
of
this.
So you're not going to a panel, you're going to the balls in the draw.
That's true. We go into the balls in the draw, yeah.
Right, so okay. Just checking.
Sorry, Lee. Sorry. Love your watch.
104.
Ah, 104. That's me, Andy. And this is a special ball, actually, yellow 104. It's the shed ball. What the shed ball is this is all the DJs that are playing at the weekend at the shed picnic. And they are, in no particular order, Ryan Walker, Eggman, Biko, Adam Dixon, and of course, John Hemming himself. They'll all be playing with friends and relatives at the outdoor arena, which is the picnic, which will take place on the Saturday afternoon. It says here, all the DJs doubted their sexuality at school, and two of them ended up with fannies.
You decide which two.
148.
You've worked with this fella, Lee, actually. Guyver.
Excellent.
Yes, indeed. A Tidy legend. And apparently, you'd be pleased about this, he's working on some new stuff for Tidy 2. Mm. Now, this is, a little known fact, but Guy has never seen another man wee, only in films. His favourite thing to look through is cling film.
Sounds about right.
Yeah, you've seen him do it.
You know him. You know him well.
55.
55 is Nicholson, or Carl Nicholson to his friends. Big Hard Trancer is back. He's had some massive tracks out recently, and he's got a new album coming out on Tidy 2. It says here, Carl's biggest wish is for all lesbians to be pretty.
I'm not sure you can say that.
No, that's his wish. He wants them all. Every single one.
Number 53.
Is that you?
Is it me?
Yeah.
53.
Was it 153? No, can't be. 53. Can't be in the
50s.
Only
153. 53. Thanks, Ben. Oh, Nick Sentience. Great to see his ball pop out. The nucleus. So it's great to see Nick's ball pop out. This nucleus legend is currently working an album due out soon on Tidy, which is exciting news. Now then, Nick's bathroom taps are not connected to the wall properly, which could be deemed to be quite dangerous.
Check on that. We'll send somebody around, Nick.
Number 99.
Oh dear. Oh good. It's Steve Lidd. Steve Lidd, infamous promoter and trance DJ. Quite a kind man.
Very nice. I like him.
He said that he'd love to kiss in public places, but he's too scared. He's not scared to speak his mind, though, when it comes to temping bowling shoe hire or the fluctuating price of kitchen roll.
Yeah, always.
Have you ever been bowling with him?
I have,
yeah. Oh, he goes on and on.
On and on about the shoes. On and on and on.
Never get a pair that fits.
Yeah.
72.
72. Is that you? Is that me?
That's you, I think.
72. Oh, the Knuckleheads.
Oh.
The rocking hard house sound of the Knuckleheads, I would like to say. AKA John Langford. His inclusion should please many of you. Very credible DJ. However, John always insists you take your shoes off when he's cooking pasta.
Number 109.
Oh, I'm on. 109, exactly.
109.
Thank you. That is Dave Pearce.
Dangerous.
Dave Pearce. Dangerous makes a return. Dangerous.
I call him that.
Dangerous Dave, I call him. He makes a return to Tiny 25 with some big crowd-pleasing trance anthems. Dave likes climbing trees to get closer to birds and fruit. His favourite part of the horse is the ears. You knew that, didn't you?
42.
The Tidy DJs, aka Sam and Dino. He's going to be pleased, isn't he, Sam?
Yeah.
He's on the gig. The lads from Leeds are back and firm favourites at the weekend. Sam has recently fallen out with his chiropodist after an argument about the way sheep are left to sleep outside. Dino was once arrested for pushing over a florist.
All cleared up now, though.
Number 21.
21, thank you. Lee, from one Lee to another. This is Lee Green, now a firm part of the Tidy team. He said if his ball didn't come out, he'd set fire to his pubic hair and send the ashes to Channel 4. Lee likes to softly kiss postman's fingers when they put their fingers through the letterbox to let them know how thankful he is of the gifts.
Right. We rang every DJ just to get these
facts,
insights.
Number 51.
51, that's you.
Okay. Oh, wow. Can we afford this one?
Go on.
So, bit of a headliner for you here. Eddie Halliwell is returning to the Weekender. Now, when did he last play at Weekender?
I can't remember. He was at Tidy Weekender 1 and 2.
I thought this had never happened, but Eddie Halliwell, your ball has come out of the fishbowl. So Eddie's back at the Weekender with a bit of bosh. Did you know that Eddie eats raspberries? When he eats raspberries, his nose swells up to the size of a postman's shoe.
Ooh, that's massive, isn't it?
Huge. So Eddie Halliwell is at the Weekender.
Good.
Excited by that.
Number 92.
Number 92, that is Marky G. Madman Mark, who was actually on the ball draw last time we were here.
Nutter.
A bit of a nutter. And Mark eats very fast. He can eat a loaf of bread and a punnet of strawberries in less than 90 seconds. We'll get him to do that soon.
We should do that.
By the way, your balls haven't... No. You realise?
Yeah, like so, yeah, we're getting a bit thinner there, aren't we?
Yeah, carry on. Good luck.
Awkward if they don't come out.
A bit embarrassing.
78,
I think that's you.
Flash Harry, aka Paul Chambers, who's been with Tidy from the start and claims to have the largest collection of unused ice tongs in England. He still can't work out why Fireman's helmets have to be so big. So Flash Harry returns.
No point, are they?
Yeah, way too big.
Especially at the back.
Number 139.
That's me. It's shining out on me. Joe Longbottom. Now, if anybody remembers, Joe won the clear winner of the poll that we did online. And so he got an automatic place, really. So his ball was always destined to come out. He loves the taste of human tit milk, but was once tempted to taste a pregnant female fox's. He did stop when it turned nasty.
Another duo, Ben Kay and Johnny Dangerous.
Ooh.
Ben and Johnny back to back. Now we believe they have not played together before, so this should be interesting or a disaster, I'm not sure. Ben has odd shaped knuckles, which stop him from joining judo classes, and Johnny recently nearly drowned by chasing a dragonfly away from a farmer's sandwich. Right.
I just pictured that for a minute. I knew there'd be one that ruined it.
Number 141.
141, that's me.
I think that's you.
Oh, right. Bryn Whittin. Hands in the air, it's Bryn Whittin. Tidy fan turned DJ and producer. Bryn has never eaten a spring onion or a radish. He says they're too hot and he's worried they might still contain soil. Because they do come out of the ground, don't they?
Yes. Okay. 91.
Do you want a drink?
Yes, please. Yeah.
There you go.
91. Cheers.
Is that nice?
That's lovely. What was it again, sorry?
91.
Okay. 91, according to this list of numbers and DJ names, is Spencer Green.
Ooh.
Or Spencer G, as he's called as a disc jockey.
Yeah.
Now, Spencer's been with Tidy, been part of the Tidy team over the years, and has, I'm going to start again with that, I'm going to be honest with you.
Well, he's live.
I know. Spencer Green, comma, who has been part of the Tidy team over the years, is back for some untidy action. Spencer now likes to relax at home by drawing pictures of angry train drivers and pregnant flat-chested women who can't express milk.
Hey, there's not many to go. I don't know how many numbers we got, but...
Sorry.
Number 98.
98, that's me, looks to camera, reads. It's the Sharp Boys.
Wow.
Your favourite, my favourite. No, we're big fans of the Sharp Boys. But Stephen and George are back together for this one, so the legendary Sharp Boys return to Tidy. Big inspiration to everything we do, actually. Both have the same fear of catching their fingers in a pair of castanets.
Terrible stuff.
Next.
107. Oh, Vinyl Groover, hardcore session from Vinyl Groover, who's aka Scott Attrell, who says there's no point in ironing pyjamas as they get wrinkled in bed anyway. It's got a point. Scott thinks all girls under 11 should own a skipping rope. He says there are lots of fun. There's lots of fun to be had if they use properly.
That's right.
It's a good bit of advice.
Good. Well done, Scott. Next. Balls are going down, Lee.
Nothing yet.
46.
46 is John BW, top producer who plans to make a return to the Tidy label this year. John claims he can kiss his own penis while doing a forward roll. He can also make scrambled eggs by just using the buckle from a school satchel.
Number three.
Oh, Nilos. Remember him?
Yes, of course I do.
Liverpool DJ has played at many Tidy Weekenders. Neil Thomas is a softly spoken man who refuses to water plants in case he gets his hands dirty. Nilos. I give you.
I used to call him Nellos.
Well, I asked Sam and he said that's how you pronounce that one.
Number 142.
142, that's on sheet 17. I thought it was Carl Cox there, but it's not. It's NG Residence and PhD. Young Pete Berry and old Phil Docker unite for some banging hard trance. These two recently have been caught holding hands at traffic lights, which is, I suppose, only natural. It says here, they do that because something happened under a motorway bridge 3 years ago. That just doesn't make sense.
No.
That just doesn't make sense. And whoever wrote it needs telling off. Carry on, then. Well done to Phil.
Number 54.
Number 54. Nearly there. Take a breather. Number 54. Unit 13, known as Jay Flynn to his friends and relative. Unit 13's hard trance hits The Weekender. Jay's really good looking, and if he was gay, I would certainly try it on with him in the toilets.
I wrote that. I knew that he'd get that one.
Thank you.
Number 66.
66, hooray. Mark Kavanagh, and from Ireland, of course, top DJ from Ireland. He's been around as long as the Tidy Boys, so he must be getting on. Makes a return to Prestatyn. Mark hates it when newsreaders blink too often, and he has a keen interest in how ships are took apart when they're no longer needed. Ooh, they're getting obscure now, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
137.
Which is your lucky number?
It is indeed.
Who is it?
It's Signum. A Tidy Weekender, in my opinion, would not be a Weekender without Signum. Ron has the largest feet in trance, did you know? His shoes are made specially for him, and it's almost impossible to push him over, even on slippery surfaces. Just picture the size. Next time, have a look.
Push him over.
Huge.
Huge feet. You know what they say about huge feet, Lee, don't they?
Big shoes?
No, massive cock.
That's what you say. 117.
It's a fix, surely. It's Lee Haslam. Oh, oh, well done, Lee.
Great
well
news. Done. Great news.
Worried. Lee Haslam, old tidy label manager, it says here, and hard trance producer, of course. So pleased for him, it tells me to say here. It says here, please say you're pleased for him. Lee gets turned on by watching other men swim. We know that, don't we? And he recently won a special award in Germany for owning the nicest leather jacket in Europe.
I did, yeah, very true.
Now, I'd love to have brought that in. Can you bring it in next time?
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you. Well done, Lee. Well done, you can relax.
How many more do you reckon now?
I don't know, probably about 12, 10, 7?
106.
106.
106. Oh, curveball. Nick Frost.
Oh, well, he said he wanted his ball in.
Nick. TV and film superstar, I say again, TV and film superstar Nick Frost is to make his DJ debut in the Queen Vic at Tidy 25.
Oh.
That's pretty special, isn't it?
It's pretty special, yeah.
He's literally going to do this. Nick says he will be very nervous and plans to bring his lucky charm, which is an Edwardian coffee table with licorice legs. Nick Frost at the Weekender.
Yeah.
That's worth coming for.
That's just worth coming for that.
Number 41.
Number 41 is DJ Lolly.
Fair play.
Nice surprise for Lolly. It says here she's got a very flexible spine and loves to change light bulbs months before they go dull.
What a strange woman.
Ah. Waste of money, I'd say. What do you think, Ben?
Not the best idea.
Okay.
138.
138,
that's you.
38.
You.
Oh.
Oh.
You're in.
Hey, Ben Stevens is here.
Big sigh of relief in the room as the hard man, Mr. Vicious Circle himself, Ben Stevens' ball is pulled out. Now then, Ben, this is true because you did tell me this. Ben once made a pair of trousers out of old lollipop sticks and says he would love to see a gymnast who has a hair lip and cleft palate win an Olympic gold. That's lovely. Yeah, yes, inclusive. Yeah, that absolutely. Really is nice, Ben.
Number 111.
Shouldn't laugh, should we? 111.
Inclusivity, that.
Inclusivity. Wow. Captain Tinrib live. Now, that's a bit of a coup. Nautical captain returns from Australia to perform a special Tidy 25 live set. That's going to be good. Tinrib hopes one day to change people's opinion on Indian taxi drivers and has a new business idea which will redefine the way cricket bats are made.
Has he? Who was that again?
That's Captain Tinrib.
You are?
Wow. Well done to the captain. Not many left, I'll be honest with you.
94.
Really?
Yeah.
He's made it. His ball's come out.
Who?
Damo Cassetti. Is that how you pronounce it?
It
Cassetti.
Is, yeah.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely.
So Damo is a very popular Leeds-based DJ with hair so blonde, it actually doesn't look real, which is true. His voice can be disturbing, again, true fact, if you haven't got an open mind. He used to be popular with the ladies until a recent hot, fat scolding incident in a local chip shop.
Nasty.
Damo.
Well done, Damo. Couple more to go, I think. It says on my list, we're very close to the end.
Number 132.
132 is Riley and Durant. I said that like an Irish. Riley. Riley and Durant. Nick and Andy have fantastic success both in radio and clubland, of course, with their Distorted podcast. They've got a great business downstairs, actually, where we are. Both still look quite young for their age, and they claim to have eaten 865 apples in the last 12 years.
Good fact. Good fact.
Thanks for sending that fact in. I think we've only got about two left. What about you? Two or three?
Two more, three more spaces on the lineup.
We've only got two more, three more spaces. So it could be all over.
110.
110? It's a tidy girl.
Oh, yeah.
It's Anne Savage. Anne is back She's fast and furious after a recent album,
yep.
Full Throttle, and used to think that bats automatically attacked people with long hair. She still doesn't believe they are blind and has written a new book about it called Keep Away From Caves.
I'm having that.
Keep away from
caves. There's two more, actually. Two more, I think. Two more spaces to go from the main draw.
Number five.
Lucky bastard. It's Andy Whitby. Andy Whitby is playing. Ooh. He's the king of bounce returns to Prestatyn. Andy has a beard made of brown iron filings. As a child, he used to chase dogs until they coughed up blood. Andy can perform a special trick where he can make his elbow skin look like the camp TV chef Ainsley Harriott.
It's a good one. Okay, I'm good at the end there.
One more. We've got one more on the main draw. This is it.
Number 89.
89.
Number 89.
Who is you got on the your last list?
It's Craig Lee.
Ah. Oh.
And now, although Craig entered the DJ pole competition, he was always earmarked for this event, so his ball was always going to be in there. Now, Craig hates it when shops close early on Sundays and has recently learned how to fix a fading torch without changing the batteries. Good trick.
Well done to Craig. So, at this point, we take a deep breath because we've got all the balls out, we've got all the DJs playing, but we've got two lucky winners that are going to be announced for the DJ pole winners.
Okay.
Now, a lot of people are still tuned in for that. So let's just take a dramatic pause. Went well, didn't it? Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah.
Nice. Really pleased.
Pleased, Lee. Really pleased. Were you worried, weren't you, before you went on?
I'm always worried where you're concerned.
You did well not to laugh, though. I think you did.
I think Ben actually laughed first. So
yeah. Okay. Right, we won't keep them waiting any longer.
Right.
For effect, even though we do know who the two winners are, because let me tell you, we've had judges and we've listened to all the mixes on Spotify. We have been, I won't put that there because it's unprofessional. We have literally gone through all the mixes. Sam Townend, Dave Jackson, Lee Green, myself, you.
Yes.
We've listened to them all. We've watched all the Facebook broadcasts live and we had to pick two winners, which was very hard. Well, I'll say half of it was hard. Mm. Do you want me to announce it rather than do the ball because we know it is?
I think now pull the ball out.
Shall we pull a ball out, shall
yeah,
we?
Yeah.
Pull a ball out and we'll pretend. But we know, but just for the for you.
For effect.
On, for effect. Go on. You pull one out firstly. Because there's on, two Luke. Winners, two lucky winners. Yeah. Yeah. And I'll pretend that it's a shock.
Number 81.
And the lucky winner, number 81, who has won the first part of this prize, yes, to play on the main stage. And when I mean the main stage, I mean the main stage during some big DJs at peak time is...
Go on.
It is Discam. Mm. Discam.
Yes.
Of course. Well done to Chris. He came in, he blew everybody's ears to bits. It was a fantastic mix. He said he spent a long time on it. It was very professional.
It was exceptional.
It was a mashup to end all mashups. So well done to Chris. Discam, you'll be playing, you'll be shitting yourself now. You're going to be on the main stage between some very big DJs. So well done to Chris. Ben, do you want to pull another ball out for effect here?
Number 84.
And number 84.
Drum roll.
You loved them.
Yeah.
There were two of them.
Cheeky chaps, weren't they?
Cheeky chaps from Ireland. It's Mickey G and Mickey Bo. Well done to those two. Obviously, we've not told them. This is live and this is the first time they're going to hear about it, so they're probably falling off the chair. Well done to the two Mickeys. Your set was entertaining. It was professional. It was well mixed. We've listened to it again. And also, you had a big smile on your face. And you reminded me of two young tidy boys back in the day. So well done to Discam and the two Mickeys. You'll be playing on the main stage at the Weekender. And before we finish, it's a bit of a surprise.
Go on.
For all the people that did enter the competition, we thought all the mixes were good, weren't they, Ben? We all sat there and we couldn't, you know, they all deserve
a prize. It.
So what we're going to do on the Friday at the Weekender, we are going, I've turned to that camera now because it's more dramatic, we are going to do a Queen Vic takeover. So all the other DJs, you want me to go back over here, do you? Yeah, okay. Okay, I'll go back over there. All the other DJs that entered the competition, You have got a slot in the Queen Vic on the Friday. We're going to have a big mashup, a Queen Vic takeover for everybody else. You're all invited to come to the weekend and play with us, and your name will be on the flyer and everything like that. So well done to everybody else.
Super. That's part. Super news.
That's super news. So well done to these two for laughing not too much, getting the balls right. Let me just...
Missed a few balls out there. A few DJs not made it. Who was that?
112. Patrick Toppin.
Bollocks.
John, another one.
Yeah.
Who's that one?
It's Andy Farley.
Oh, well, okay, we better move on. Thank you. See, it's live, anything can go wrong. Thank you for joining us tonight. We can't answer all your lots of feeds and people writing things down and saying what a good lineup it is. We can't reply tonight. We're going to go off, have a big shit and a piss, and we'll try and come back online in a minute. But thank you very much for joining us. So don't forget, the Weekender is this summer at Prestatyn. We're going back to our faithful place, the Prestatyn. Yep. Let's not forget, we're celebrating 25 years of Tidy. Not many labels and events get to 25, do they, Andy?
25 years.
We're going back to Prestatyn. No other brand in the world can take you back to the dance floor to see the same DJs playing the same music at the same place with the same smells. So come back. Come back, please, to Prestatyn on the 10th and 11th. And like I said, go to tidy25.com to book your tickets. Thank you very much. Good night. God bless. Thank you. Well done.
Thank you very much. Well done. Really good.
Thank you. Your shoes look great.
Thanks.
Very shiny. Are they new? Where'd you get them from?
Yeah.
The eyes.
Splashed out. Yeah.
Nice, really good.
Oh, apparently we've got to walk off. Okay. We're still live.
All right.
Well, I need a piss.
Yeah. So, why did Lashes Ball not come out?
Well,
I thought you'd have sorted that.
We did put the ball in, but she told us to take it out because she'd booked, she'd got a previous engagement.
Oh, shit.
Andy Farley, we booked him.
Yeah.
We put his ball in, but he told us to take it out.
Right.
Because he is on holiday.
Ah, right.
With his boyfriend.
Where's he going?
Somewhere in Tenerife.
Yeah. I'd love to have Glasby there.
Glasby?
I'd love to have Glasby.
Wow, there's a story there. I can't tell you. Let's just put... I'll say one word. Immigration.
Oh.
Okay. That's all I'm saying. Passport not allowed. Yeah. Okay. So no Glasby, no Lashes. But they've all got good reasons, yeah? So if anybody asks you in the street or online, just tell them the truth. They've double booked and Glasby's out the country.
Right. Got it.